Thanks to Netflix, Prime Video, Disney Plus, etc., people are only going to movie theaters now if the film promises to be an adventure park ride. Exciting, flashy, big. What's bigger than dinosaurs? Hey all, my name is Acharita. This is my channel. Welcome! You're watching a movie review and today we're talking about Jurassic World Dominion. Before I start, subscribe kar lo ek baar, hai? Kya ja raha hai? Free service de rahi hun. Rebooting the Jurassic Park franchise was a Hollywood decision I was deeply invested in. It felt like if someone had said, "Hey Suchu, remember when you were 6 years old and you saw your first Hollywood movie and it happened to be a Steven Spielberg masterpiece about an imaginary world and reptiles and heroes and it had children doing some major problem solving. Would you like to feel that rush of euphoria again?"
I promise you, I am gonna get her back.
Chris Pratt, Bryce Dallas Howard, more children and Irfan Khan ko lekar. Jab pehli film in the new series announced hui thi, meri khushi ka thikana shabdon mein bayan nahi kar sakti main. You see, Irfan Khan was the perfect casting choice to replace the owner of ill-advised amusement park shoes left empty by the heavyweight Richard Attenborough. Anything Irfan touched had instant gravitas, deep purpose, a larger meaning. Don't you just miss him so much every day? Alas, what we got was a theme park ride and not a movie with an actual beating heart. Jimmy Fallon had a cameo, right? The stakes didn't feel important or high enough. The visuals, while very impressive, special effects just didn't have the same impact as seeing an early 90s Samuel Jackson chain smoking while wondering, "Is park ki lighte on kaise karenge dobara?" Then came Jurassic World Fallen Kingdom, which despite adding to the cast an actor like Toby Jones and a guest appearance from Jeff Goldblum himself, was so utterly forgettable, I couldn't tell you a single scene right now. I remember it feeling like a horror film and dinosaurs were being sold at auctions, but little else. Which is why watching Dominion, I was so confused because I felt like I'd missed a movie in between. I had no memory of a whole subplot involving a human clone. And the only thing I actually remembered was the raptor named Blue, who Chris Pratt had miraculously managed to somewhat train in Jurassic World. And then in a final attempt to tug at our heartstrings, Dominion brings back the amazing Laura Dern, who appears in this also, wearing an orange front-tied shirt like she hasn't had a chance to update her wardrobe in 30 years. But it's Laura Dern, and I'm here for whatever sartorial choices she makes. Sam Neill is back as Alan Grant, the OG Chris Pratt could never. And Jeff Goldblum is as Jeff Goldblum-y as ever. And every single time these three are on screen, meeting each other, you know, after a gap of years, they're catching up. I feel like they're checking in on me. How have I been all these years? How has my life changed since we all had that crazy dinosaur adventure together?
Everybody hold on to somebody.
Jurassic World Dominion is a gigantic, fun, dazzling watch, even if it lacks the heart of the original. The good bad guy, head of a science company, hell-bent on making all the wrong decisions is Campbell Scott, phoning it in yet another Steve Jobs type CEO. Ho gaya na abhi thoda? And there are many, many homages to the original, too many to keep track of. My favorite though was the reappearance of the very same shaving cream can which Dennis Nedry stole from InGen to give to rival science company Biosyn. Another scene I enjoyed was a huge T-Rex peering into the windows of an upside down car looking for people as survivors scampered around behind it. Bahut hai aise, a seatbelt that doesn't quite work properly, etc, etc. But Dominion moves away from the beats of the disaster movie genre. The disaster you see has already occurred. Dinosaurs are loose all over the world and now we just need a hero to round them up to one island. All is already lost. We're simply now in one long climax sequence of the final act. Chris Pratt is a dino herding cowboy who can also ride bikes in streets of Italy or was it France? Like he's James Bond, except the bad guys chasing him are trained to kill dinosaurs. It's so cheesy, so enjoyable. This motorbike sequence in particular, which ends up culminating on an airplane runway, just some solid Hollywood stunt work. Despite the presence of the original cast and huge scary dinosaurs, the one person who stole the show for me was Bryce Dallas Howard. Her character arc is the only one worth emotionally investing in and she gets a lot of the original babe lost in the woods action Laura Dern did so well in the first, except she will cut you if you come too close. And she's not wearing high heels.
That's another plane, right?
Not exactly.
Dominion is a family-friendly, Marvel-y picnic at the movies. Not enough people are eaten by dinosaurs. There is only one major jump scare, and it really leans into the capitalism is bad, let's go live in the woods vibe. The miracles of science and finding the line between innovation and weaponization is not explored here all that much. Only one scientist, a minor character, is feeling some sort of guilt over using his know-how to mess with the order of nature, which are his only speaking lines. The film also has ample biblical allegories thrown in. A swarm of locusts, it's raining fire from the skies, all living creatures are diverted to one holding cell to be safe. And to create a spectacle, it's all well and good. If you're looking to be moved and really transported to a fantastic plot laid out like an escape room, watch Spielberg or read Michael Crichton's first Jurassic Park book. So on a scale of 1 to 10, Jurassic World Dominion is 3 dinosaurs I saw finally with feathers. You know how people keep saying, "Our dinosaurs actually had feathers, they were birds." Jao, dekh kar aao. पंख लगे हुए छिपके लिए. Also, who here has watched Prehistoric Planet on Apple TV yet? मैंने नहीं देखा, पर देखना मेरे को. Tell, subscribe करके जाओगे लेकिन, please, है ना? 50,000 तक पहुंचा दो जल्दी से.